So one of the main influences in a winter forecast is the state of ENSO, or whether we're in a state of El Niño or La Niña in the equatorial Pacific. And this year, we will be in a second year La Niña in the equatorial Pacific. How we determine whether or not we're in a state of El Niño or La Niña is based on the sea surface temperature anomalies in the equatorial Pacific. And you can see here that there are currently below normal sea surface temperature anomalies in the equatorial Pacific. And the models forecast that to be the case throughout this entire winter. So we will be in a state of a weak to a moderate La Niña throughout the winter. A secondary factor that we can look at on a seasonal basis is the northern Pacific, whether or not we have a warm or cool blob in the Gulf of Alaska. This winter, we just so happen to have a cool blob in the Gulf of Alaska. When you combine these two features, that means two things. Number one, we will have a predominant Pacific Northern Branch storm track across the United States, meaning we'll have a lack of big Gulf and East Coast winter snowstorms. So I think overall, we'll have a lot of nuisance events this winter, changeover events, 1 to 3 inch snowfalls, but overall, the predominant storm track should be to our north and west, meaning that I foresee a lack of the potential of a big 12 inch plus snowstorm. As far as temperatures are concerned, in a second year La Niña, since we've been in that base state for a year already, the climate tends to act fully like a La Niña, whereas in a first year La Niña, if we've come out of an El Niño in the year before, sometimes there'll be a lag effect and it really won't act like a La Niña pattern. But given that this is a second year La Niña, I fully expect that the overall weather pattern across the United States will act like a La Niña. And typically, what does that mean for us? That means, again, we'll have that fast storm track across the northern tier, and it usually means that there'll be a lack of cold shots across the United States. Not to say that we can't get a few chilly days here and there, or alternating warm and cold shots, but I think overall that we'll have more warm shots than we will cold shots, and the number of warm days will outnumber the number of cold days. We will have a big swings, ups and downs throughout the winter. However, I think the ups will be much greater than the downs on average. The cool blob in the northern Pacific, what that tends to do is enhance a trough or a general area of low pressure over Alaska and the Pacific Northwest. So what that means across the United States is you have this westerly flow directed from the Pacific Ocean into the western part of the United States, and oftentimes, because you have this strong westerly flow across the western U.S., the cold air gets locked up in Canada, and there's really no way to tap into that here in the eastern United States. So anytime you get that fast zonal flow from the Pacific Ocean, what tends to happen is you get mild air streaming across the entire United States, and I think we'll see that quite frequently this winter. I think that overall temperatures will be slightly above normal through the winter, about 1 to 3 degrees above normal, and I think snowfall will be slightly below normal, or about 15 to 25 inches here in Lancaster County. The normal seasonal snowfall over the last 40 years here at Millersville is about 28 inches. So again, you can see that I think we'll be a few inches, or to even several inches below that. January is the one month that stands out this winter where we do have the potential for more prolonged periods of cold and wintry weather. Again, I don't think that we're going to see any truly big snowstorms this winter, but we do have the potential to see one 4 to 8 or 6 to 10 inch event, and I think the most likely month in which that happens would be January. As far as December is concerned, the pattern looks very mild. I think temperatures in December will average at least 1 to 3 degrees above normal. And then in a second year La Niña, oftentimes you do get that cold shot in January, and then the pattern flips back to what it was in December by the time we get back to February. So I think that in February, we'll see temperatures well above normal again, on the order of 2 to 4 degrees above normal here in Lancaster County, with below normal snowfall. Again, I do think that most storms this winter will track to our north and west, but that doesn't mean that we can't get some snow and ice on the front end of those systems. I think when that happens, it would be brief. Again, the 1 to 3, 2 to 4 inch events, ultimately with a changeover to rain, but I think we'll see several of those throughout the winter. And no real true nor'easters, at least not here in Lancaster County. There is the potential up in northern New England, but down here in Lancaster County, the potential is minimal at best.